of the integrand, but really this is not necessary. It is necessary if you integrate with respect to an additive process. There might be some additive processes where you need to do it, but if you integrate with respect to a Levy process, you don't need, and you can do it in the same way you do it with the Brownian motion. Okay. Oh, I'm sorry. So now, I should not say stupid things if you record it, but... Okay.
Sorry, can I ask only a question?
Yeah.
When you say that integrating against a Levy process is the same integrating that from a Poisson random measure?
No, I'm not saying this. Integrating with respect to a Poisson random measure is more general than integrating with respect to a Levy. What I was saying is that today I just discuss integration with respect to the process, not with respect to the compensated Poisson random measure. I still don't need it here, still not, yeah? Because I am only integrating with respect to a process. And we will see that if you integrate, I mean, like you integrate with respect to a martingale. But in this particular martingale case, this particular martingale has so nice properties that the Itô integral with respect to a is exactly defined in the same way as in the Brownian case. You don't need special properties like the integral to be integral to be predictable or so. Yeah? It's the definition is exactly the same. We will see this. And then I would like also to speak about integration with respect to the compensated Poisson random measure, but first I have obviously to introduce it and to make the Levy-Itô decomposition and so on. And this will be more general. Okay. But we were still speaking about martingales. So what is a martingale for a stochastic process? Now, you can imagine that I go on with my numbering, definition 7. A stochastic process MT is a martingale. On a filtered space omega f, ft if so this is similar for the time series, the expectation of if the first moment is finite for all t in R plus, and 2, for each s less than t, the following holds. It holds that given any measurable set in the sigma algebra at time s, the expectation of the indicator function A of times ms is equal to the expectation of multiplicated with the indicator function on A of mt. So there is a balance keeping on in time to be true. Okay, I remember now I'm speaking in general for processes with values in some separable Banach space. Okay, so now somebody was doing, it was you maybe, a question?
About the definition.
Yeah, about the definition, because in some book you might find this, for example, Revuillard, But in most of the book, you find a different definition. But the two definitions are equivalent, as proven also in Rebouillard. So I took it from Rebouillard. So let me now recall the other definition. Yeah? In order to recall the other definition, let me first remember that there is the following theorem, which I won't prove because it's not now the topic here. And you can find, for example, in the Pratto-Zapchik book, but
others,
obviously. And it says the following. Given a random variable x on some probability space, omega fp, with finite moment, and now given a sub sigma algebra G, so G, the set in G are also set in F, and G is a sigma algebra. Then there exists a unique. Do you agree if I, for existence, I put this and unique, I put this? There exists a unique as a symbol. Random variable. Which we denote with EX condition G, like this. On this probability space with the sigma algebra G, so omega GP, so this new random variable is measurable with respect to G, such that the following holds. For all A in G, all measurable set in the sigma, in the sub-sigma algebra, the expectation of the indicator function multiplicated with this so-called conditional expectation with respect to G is equal to the expectation of the indicator function A times X. So we have a random variable which is measurable on a smaller sigma algebra, but on those sets of this smaller sigma algebra, it has the same expectation. Okay, so if you now believe that this theorem is true, so it's proven, so it's true, you can imagine what is the relation.
So G must contain all null sets.
All?
Null sets.
Ah, okay. Yes, I agree. I should maybe say, yeah, it is complete. Yeah? Okay, thank you.
And about this problem, if you, in your filtration, you input the collection.
In my filtration, in any case, said that it is a usual condition that assume everything to be complete. By the way, now we have some example where it might be useful, but one of the example. But obviously, here I should mention it because I assumed this for the filtration, but not in this theorem. So yes, G is complete. Okay, we assume. All sigma algebras to be complete. Okay, thank you. So, by the way, yes, I said this, but I didn't write it. This is called the conditional expectation of X with respect to the sigma algebra G. Now, we remark definition of martingales, a stochastic process. Mt on the filtered space omega f ft, and here we assume that everything was complete by the usual condition, p is a martingale if and only if for all bigger than s, the conditional expectation of the martingale condition to the filtration at time s is equal to ms. And this is the definition you usually find in the books. Usually you find this definition to be a martingale, right? But I liked very much the way of Revuillard, because it's giving you a feeling what a martingale is. It's giving you the feeling that some balance holds and still holds for future time, right? While here you have to, it's harder to understand this balance problem.
You have the fair games you will.
Yeah, sure. I mean also, but. So I was reading Revuillard when I was a PhD student, and I loved this book to be so clear. Yeah. Okay. Revuillard. I have it copy there. Yeah. Okay. So now we look at the following space. So let P theta equal 1 be fixed. Less than infinity, I think. Then we call MTP of E, or shortly we write it simply MTP. The space of martingales, which E-valued martingales, E was in our case a Banach space, separable Banach space, of E-valued martingales on the filtered space, on a given filtered space, omega f ft p, such that the pth moment is finite. The pth moment at time big T is finite. Okay, so let also the time big T fixed. Okay, so this is a Banach space. So theorem, MTP, the space of martingales with pth finite moment, is a Banach space. With norm, the one that you can imagine, given by the moment. So the norm of MTP is equal to the expectation of the norm MT of P of 1 over P. So I will prove this. Up to now, until now, I made some course especially for you in a little bit special way, but time to time, I refer to some results in a book like for example now, and also in the future more often, in a book together that we are preparing together with Mandrika and Tappe. So I would like to cite them here. So the reference is somehow book in preparation for Springer Verlag. We are a little bit late, so I hope they won't be angry with us, but in principle, by Atma Mandrika. I mean, the name of Atma is only a nickname. Some Indian person might tell me how is the name? Vidiman. Okay, sorry. And Tappe, and also about stochastic differential equation with Levinois on and partial differential equation with Levinois on Banach space. Okay. I don't remember the title, but anyway, it's SPDE. E, well, it's both with Levinois. Okay, so for example, the proof here of the theorem. It is important maybe that I prove it, because when we define the Itô integral, we will see, you do it in the usual way, and the Itô integral is defined how? For example, for Brownian motion. You define it on some sample function, some step function, and you see that on the step function, if it's Hilbert valued, you have an isometry, and due to this isometry, you are able to, and due to this isometry and due to the fact that the step function are dense in the LP space, you are able to close the operator as an operator on the whole LP space with values in this Banach space here. Yeah? So for this reason, I would like to prove this theorem. So in order to prove the theorem, let me first make a notation. Let LP FT of E be the Banach space of E valued random variables on the probability space with the sigma algebra at time t. So omega ft p. And with the finite norm, okay, finite is obviously, but I mean, with norm xp equal to the expectation of the norm of x to the p of 1 over p. Okay. So now to prove the theorem, maybe I should write here, because otherwise the people behind us in the room. show that there is an isometry phi from the space of the martingales with pth moment. To the LP space on omega F T. No, I called it like this, I think. And the norm P. Where, in fact, to every martingale, I can give the value of the martingale at time big T. And I mean, here we know that this is a Banach space and this is an isometry. Phi is an isometry, the way I define the norms. Moreover, we also know that phi is surjective. So for any random variable here, you will find a martingale such that at time big T, the value of the martingale is this random variable. So P is surjective because given X in this LP space, I can define as a martingale T the expectation of X condition to FT. And this is really a martingale here. I can show you this. I mean, it's a nice exercise if you like. In fact, it is in order to prove now that it is a martingale, I should prove that the first moment is finite. So here I make an inequality, which in principle I should prove this. But I ask you to look this in the books because a question of time. So it is really the first moment finite because this inequality for conditional expectation hold. So in some sense, a clean proof, I should show this. But now let us assume that we know this. Then I have only to show that given two different times, S prime less than S, then given any measurable set in the filtration at time S prime, which is the smallest time, the expectation of the indicator function of this martingale, which here is the conditional expectation of X to Fs prime, is equal to the expectation of the indicator function in the conditional expectation of X condition to the bigger time Fs. Can you read here? Okay, so and this is really true because both of these are equal by definition of conditional expectation to the indicator function A times X. This is true in both cases because A as a set is not only measurable in Fs prime, but it's also measurable as we have here a filtration in Fs. So A is also measurable in Fs. So for both cases, this equality has to hold by definition. So this is a martingale. So what I created here is a surjective isometry. Yeah?
So that.
And this is a Banach space.
First moment is finite because of this tower property, right?
Yes, which I didn't prove, but it is true, and you have to maybe check it in the books. Yeah. Yeah, that the first moment is finite, exactly. Okay. So this is interesting for a later result. And now let us look at other properties of martingale. So here I speak about Levy processes, which have so many nice properties. So experts of you might feel disturbed if I avoid some very important concepts, which are important for the generality. But in this case, if somebody really doesn't know anything about stochastic analysis, can be avoided. So I will avoid them. For example, I won't now go in the details of what is a bracket of a martingale, because in this particular case that we will consider, where the brackets are simply given by a linear function of the time t, we don't need now the whole theory to be presented in these 7 hours I have here. But everything I present is self-consistent. Without these generalities, we need for more general martingales. Okay. So, theorem, let us look at some properties of martingale, which are really very important to define the Itô integral. Let MT now be a martingale in this MT2 space. So the second moments are finite. And now I take it Hilbert valued. We will integrate with respect to Levy processes, which are real valued. Functions, which are Hilbert value, and maybe I tell you how to do it when they are Banach valued. So for this, this is for me enough to now to look at this, yeah, for this case. For integrating with respect to martingale, which are maybe not real valued, there are many experts also here, like I think Brezhnev, for example, is one of them, who in the past did some stochastic integration, who will come. Okay, so H now separable Hilbert space. With norm, usual norm symbol. So let me remark that for each t bigger than s, the expectation of the norm of mt square minus m s square is equal to the expectation of the norm of mt minus ms square. Okay, so as a consequence, remark that the function, I call it so, mt is increasing in time. Okay, the proof is really simple. We have only to have the notion of what is a martingale. And okay, maybe we need some additional lemma. Eventually, we might prove it in the tutorial. But it is a very intuitive lemma. And this tells us the following, that given a martingale, which is in the space of martingales with finite second moment, and let S less be to T. I consider here again H-varied martingale. If I have a random variable which is adapted at time fs adapted, so it's measurable at time s to the filtration, or better to say fs measurable, then if I make the expectation of the brackets of ms with x due to the martingale property, it is easy to show that this is the same as the expectation of the bracket of mt with x. You can imagine how to prove it, because you just do it first for indicator function, which are defined on the sets which are measurable here, and then by density of of sample function, you do it in general. Okay, so then the proof is obviously very easy. Once you know this, you have just to compute this, but this is the bracket of mt minus ms of mt minus ms, and this is equal to the expectation of the norm of mt square minus 2, the expectation of the bracket mt, ms, plus the expectation of norm of ms square. And then you see immediately that this is the expectation of the norm of mt square minus 2, the expectation of the norm of ms square, plus the expectation of the norm of ms squared, because I am using the lemma here, and ms is measurable at time fs. So I just can substitute with ms, ms. Yeah? Okay. So now, we have some more properties for martingales, which are real valued and are stationary and have second moment finite. So, theorem 4, let MT now be a martingale with a finite second moment, be stationary and centered. I mean, I don't need really to be centered, but it's easier now to make it. Okay. Then I will say what stationary is, because I think I didn't do it. And such that at 0, it is equal to 0. Then there exists a constant D such that the expectation of the second moment is equal to D times D. And here is the clue somehow, because this will be the reason why we are able to define Itô integral in such an easy way for the case of Brownian motion or in general Levy processes. Okay. So I didn't say what stationary means. A process xt is stationary if given a time t bigger than s, xt, the increment in this interval of time, is equal to the increment of of the process from time zero to time t minus s. Or in other words, what I'm saying that in two intervals of the same size, the increments are equal. This is the same as saying that xt minus xs is equally distributed with xt prime minus xs prime if t prime minus s prime have the same size as t minus s. So like the Brownian motion, if you look at the path and you look at two times which all have the same size, the way it will evolve from here is exactly distributed like the way it will evolve here if the size of the intervals are equal. Okay. So, okay, how to prove the theorem? We use real analysis, and we use the results concerning this function here, which is increasing in time, and this equality here. Okay, recall analysis. If I have a function, if f from R to R is a function, so with the following property, given any delta bigger than zero and any interval, I mean, if I take t0 less than t1 and so on, less than tn, such that the size between tj plus 1 minus tj is equal to delta, if given any choice of this kind, you will observe that you have always that the value of the function in Tn is equal to f of Tj plus 1 minus Tj plus ft0, but you can be sure that this function will be a linear function. Then f is linear. And now we will see that our function here, this function here, is linear. It is linear because, I take any such choice, and then I use the result of the previous theorem. And I use also here the stationarity. This is important. And so here it's equal delta. I hope you can read it. So if I do the expectation of mt square, then I always can write it as, here I can take this to be equal t, tn to be equal t. So this is then the expectation of mtj plus 1 squared minus mtj squared plus the expectation of m0 squared. But this is 0 by assumption. And then this, by the result we had before on general martingales on Hilbert space, you can really write it as the expectation of mtj plus 1 minus mtj square. But now, due to the stationarity, you know that this is equal to the expectation, the sum of the expectation of the martingale at time tj plus 1 minus tj square. But then it follows that the function m, which is the expectation of the square of m in time t, is linear. Is linear. Moreover, m t0 equals 0 with probability 1. So, I mean, in particular, the expectation of mt0 square at time 0 is 0. And then you get that e mt square is equal to d times t. Okay. So now, in the next section, I will speak about additive processes, and these are martingales. I mean, under few assumptions, these are martingales. The few assumptions, for example, that the first moment exists, is finite at any time t. So these are the good candidate to be used for noise, for defining the noise. And if, in addition, these additive processes are stationary, then they have, for example, all the properties I mentioned here, in particular, if they have second moment finite. The second moment will increase linearly, and defining the Itô integral is exactly the same as you do it for the Brownian motion. At least as long the process is real valued, in fact also Hilbert valued wouldn't be a difference. But even Banach valued is not a difference, it's also in that case it's the same. Okay. I will mention also Banach. So additive processes. Okay, we assume again in this section at first that our processes have value in a Banach space. Okay. So let me first define what is a process with independent increments. A stochastic process on a filtered space omega f ft has independent increments. If given any time s less than t, the process xt minus xs is independent of the filtration at time s. So what this means, I said this already in the previous lectures, or yeah, yesterday. But in any case, this means that for all s less than t and a measurable set A in Fs and the border set B in BE, the probability of A intersection with the inverse image of xt minus xs of B is equal to the product. Okay, so now we can define an additive process. So a stochastic process on a filtered space. I call it here xt. So on omega f ft p is an additive process if with probability 1 it is equal to 0 times 0. It has independent increments, that means that this condition here holds. It is stochastically continuous, and it has Cadillac paths. So it is stochastically continuous. Which means that given any epsilon which is positive, the limit when s goes to t of the probability of the probability that the norm of xs minus xt is bigger than epsilon goes to 0. So the path, however, have not to be continuous. In fact, they are assumed to be Cadillac. Xt has Cadillac path. This means that the probability that that x as a function omega is Cadillac is 1. So what does it mean, Cadillac? I mean, the French imposed us this name, but if somebody is not European, I think it's hard to remember this name, right? Because Cadillac comes from continua a droite, limite à gauche. So you have to know French. And why should we know French? Okay, so let me define what is Cadillac. So a function f from R to R is Cadillac. Oh, I did the wrong. So continue drop limit à gauche if okay, it is right continuous. And the limit from the left always exist. And this finite. So simply a function which might be like this, or something like that. Okay, so remark the following, that due to the fact that it is it's Cadillac, but it's stochastically continuous, the paths are Cadillac. But if you fix a time t, the probability to find a jump is zero for a fixed time t. But nevertheless, obviously, when you define, it is nevertheless important that that the paths are Cadillac, even if at a given time the probability to find jumps is zero. Yeah. I will. Yeah, I will say this immediately. Exactly. So a Levy process is an additive process which is stationary. And the Brownian motion is defined to be a Levy process with continuous paths. You can define it that way. And then by the theorem of Levy, you know that it is Gauss distributed. I mean, and obviously you can do the contrary again, but. So Levy processes are particular additive processes, and Brownian motion is a particular Levy process. So you see, you will not wonder that integration with respect to Levy process is defined as in the case of Brownian motion. Okay, so the Levy process is a stationary additive process. Usually I write for a Levy process an L. Okay, and Brownian motion is a Levy process with continuous path. Is a, okay, a centered Levy process. Such that the probability that the paths are continuous is one. And then by Levy, I mean, you can define the Brownian motion obviously in a different way, but the definition are equivalent. For example, in this case, using the theorem by Levy, you know that the Brownian motion is Gauss distributed. And as it has all moments, yeah, it is Gauss distributed with the variance which increases linearly. Sorry? In general, by additive or Levy process, yeah, path can be, yeah, stochastically continuous. So the path itself have jumps, but the process, the probability that xs minus xt is bigger than a given constant is goes to zero when s approaches t. Between additive and Levy, yeah. It's one condition more.
Simply.
Yeah. Okay, so let us see what property we already know for Levy processes due to what we learned before concerning martingales. Yeah? And then let us define the Itô integral of, first I say Hilbert space valued random variables, processes with respect to the Levy process, but I will discuss how you can do it for Banach spaces. Maybe not in details, because maybe not everybody is so interested, but it's easy to explain in some sense. Okay, so corollary of the previous results is the following. If I have, let LT, I mean, a noise, a process defining a noise is interesting when it's centered, right? So I will only consider centered processes to later on define noises. So let LT be a centered, in this case, real valued Levy process. Such that the second moment exists for any time t. And we will see that for all Levy processes which don't have this property, they are anyway Levy processes with bounded variation. So they are not interesting candidates for being noise defining. So this property is not restrictive, yeah, to define the noise. Then we know from the previous result that the expectation of LT square is linearly increasing, which will be very useful because it's the same thing as for the Brown emotion, right? For some given d bigger than zero. And I mean, the proof, it follows directly from what we already proved, yeah? It is because LT is in the space of, it is an additive process, hence is a martingale, yeah? Did I write the theorem that any additive process with finite moment is a martingale? I mean, I forgot this, right? Oh, I'm sorry. So it was before? Sorry. I will immediately do this. It is centered. And at 0 is equal to 0 p almost surely. And then the result follows from the previous section. Was section 2, theorem 4. Yeah, I forgot to mention the following. Any additive process with finite moment is a martingale. And the proof is simply done. I leave it as an exercise, but we do it in the tutorial. And because I want you maybe to try it, it is simply done in the same way as we did it for time series. There is no difference in that. Yeah. So I forgot to write down this theorem. So theorem, it was theorem one here, which I forgot. An additive process okay, additive center process. XT with finite moment. At any time t is a martingale. So we do it in the tutorial. But really, if you remember the previous proof for time series, we just use that the increments are independent of the sigma algebra, of the previous sigma algebra. And then the proof is identical. Okay. So therefore, it's clear that a Levy process with finite second moment is, in any case, a martingale. And the second moment increases linearly, like in the Brownian motion case. Okay, but now really everything, in some sense, is done because, I mean, you already, most of you studied the Itô integral with respect to Brownian motion. What ingredients do you use to prove, define the Itô integral? You use the fact that sample functions or step functions are dense in the L2 space. You use the fact that the second moment increases linearly. And you use also the fact that the process is additive and stationary. You only use these ingredients to define the Itô integral. So everything done for Brownian motion works for this case. Now I prepare it. So I hope not to annoy you. So if somebody, if most of you have done this, it's annoying. But anyway, let me do it. Yeah? Okay. So let me do it also because very often in literature you might find things which are misunderstanding. For example, let me, by doing it, show you that you really don't need the integrand to be predictable if you integrate for a Levy process, with respect to a Levy process. This notion of predictability was introduced when integration were done in much more generality, for example, for additive processes or point processes, like Ikeda Watanabe. He does integration not only with respect to Levy processes, he considers additive processes. There you need really the integrand to be predictable. But here, you need it only to be adapted. Yeah? So let us do it. We do it in the same way as for the Brownian motion case. But as this was somehow very often doubted, we made it even more clear by a theorem I will show you, or just mention to you. But it was known, I mean. So just for the literature, Shirayev proved that if you have a martingale and the brackets are absolutely continuous with respect to the Lebesgue measure, then you don't need predictability condition when you integrate with respect to this martingale. This was, however, in a book, in a Russian book, to my opinion. He says it's in Lipster Shirayev, but finally, I didn't find it there.
Can you
and people told me
it's in a Russian version.
I didn't, yeah, I can do it in a few words, but I can do it more precise maybe next time, yeah? So in few words, it's you don't need, when you want to integrate with respect to a Levy process, to integrate with respect by taking as the sigma algebra the one generated by the left continuous processes. You need it if you integrate in general with respect to an additive process, which has not the property of being stationary. Because if it's not stationary, you don't have this. So the brackets are not linearly increasing. You even don't need it if you integrate with respect to an additive process, which has brackets which are absolutely continuous with respect to the Lebesgue measure. Even in that case, you don't need. This has to do with density properties. Okay, but this is sometimes very often in the literature, people spend in an article many pages to prove predictable any step when they integrate with respect to Levy, but it's not needed, fortunately. Okay. So now we want to define the Itô integral, yeah? So we assume the Itô integral to be exactly the one here. So assumption, LT is now a real value centered Levy process. On some filtered space. And yes, such that it is have all second moments finite, hence we know that it is in the space of martingales with second moment finite for any big T, it is in this space. So now we also know that there is this constant D such that the second moment of LT is equal to D times S. Now we want to define the Itô integral. So the question is, for what function we are able to define it? And why do we need to define it? So I call it like this, HL equal to the integral of 0 t. OK, so for any time t, obviously, of HS in DLS. So here is a point in the sense that this is a whole process, yeah, we want to define. So for what function are we able to do this? And why do we need it? I will also explain, but I think this is clear somehow because I said this also in the introduction. We do it for, we want to integrate stochastic processes, which are obviously adapted to our filtration, because if they are not adapted, it doesn't make sense to consider them at all. We cannot observe them. But also, which are in the L2 space, I mean, like in the Brownian motion case, yeah? They are defined in the L2 space with respect to the measure ds times p. So nothing new with respect to Brownian motion. So I write it like this. And with this, I will explain what I mean. I mean the space of those functions such that the second moment with respect to the product measure of the Lebesgue measure in time, and p is finite. Yeah, but obviously I need something more. I want them also to be adapted. Okay, so I will explain very well what is this. So with these other adapted processes, so is the set of all processes on the filtration, so FT adapted processes. Or how we define it, the processes on the filtered space. And L2 is like usual, but let me nevertheless write it down. Okay, I take it here with respect. Well, I take it here with respect to the Lebesgue measure with the D here, just to have later on isometry. It is the separable Banach space. In fact, it's a Hilbert space. But anyway, separable Hilbert, if you like. Of BR plus times F measurable function with second moment finite. So with finite norm. Which I will denote in this way to distinguish it from the other, such that h square is equal to d, so that this would be the norm to the square. And the process I consider are have a finite second moment with respect to this product measure here. Okay. So we do like for the Brownian case. Now there is really no difference. We first define the stochastic integral for sample function, sample processes. And then we show, I won't show it here, but if you ask me to show it, I should look at the proof. At least I will state, but this is found, I think, in many books, that the sample function are dense in this L2 space. And as we are able to define the Itô integral for the sample function and show that this is an isometry, we are then, like in the Brownian case, able to to extend the operator, which we have defined by Itô integral on the sample function, to the whole L2 space in a continuous way. This is what is done for Brownian motion. So we first define the Itô integral for sample functions. So let me define what, how these are defined. So definition, a stochastic process HS with values, now I take H, but I will explain you later how to do it for the case of separable balances. With value, but this is what you already know somehow. It's more familiar to you. On H separable Hilbert space, so here also I took as a state space H, but we will change it later. It's defined on the filtered space, where the Levy process obviously is defined, the same filtered space. Is a sample process if it is somehow a step function. So it has this form here, HE, then it's defined on some interval where T1 is less than Tn, n is in n. And what I also want is that it is adapted to the filtration. It has to be defined here. So even in some sense, if I say it's defined here, it's clear that He is Fte measurable. Okay. So remark, the set of sample function is linear. I call it SH of sample function. The definition of sample functions is related to the filtration on omega F Ft. Is linear. Sum of sample function is a sample function, and so on. And obviously, it is adapted, but this is clear. Okay, so you can find in many books the following theorem. The theorem tells you that S of H is dense in the L2 space I defined here, which, if you allow, I call it in a short way because it's too long to write it every time in this way. This is this L2 space. In L2, okay, now for experts I will do some comments later on, but not now because I see that time is not so good. You will have seen many density theorems, so one is this, but you might have seen differently. But the funny thing is that as these L2 spaces are equivalent in this case, it doesn't matter. Maybe you have seen that this is dense in the L2 space of progressively measurable function if you read, for example, Skorod's book. Or you have seen it where here is written predictable, where you mean that the sigma algebra you take is only the predictable. But in the case I am considering, which is this one, where the measure is absolute, is even the Lebesgue measure, but is it might even only be absolutely continuous with respect to the Lebesgue measure, all these spaces are isomorphic. So for experts only, this comment, if I take L2T, which I defined in this way by making the intersection with the adapted function, or I take the progressively measurable function, or I take the L2 space, which is defined like there, but only by considering not this sigma algebra here, but the predictable sigma algebra. Okay, and so on. These are all isomorphic. So in some book, you find this density theorem here. Some book, you find this density theorem here. And some book, you find this density theorem here. But they are isomorphic. And due to this isomorphism, you see that you don't need to take this sigma algebra here. Okay? So this is a result done more in general than for this case in a paper 2009 by Tappe and me. But probably something was already known in the previous, by Metivier, for example, or Shirayev. But for a concrete proof, obviously I know better mine. Okay. So, any case, now we define the Itô integral on the sample function and show that this is an isometry, and then we close the operator. See, the operator, integral operator, we close it on L2. So, so Itô integral first defined for sample function. So let HS be a sample function, which is then given in this form. In particular, then, we know that these are adapted to the time TE. The Itô integral with respect to the Levy process, I denote it like this, with respect to L, correspond is simply the Lebesgue-Schiltis integral, nothing else. It is defined pathwise. We say simply that this integral here is equal to the sum of hi lti plus 1 minus lti of omega. But you see that we can only do it because this is a sample function. Because if the variation of L is not finite, we cannot simply pathwise pass to a limit by taking here the time to be closer and closer, because it would explode. Yeah? So we have to introduce a different way of integral for general H, and this is the Itô integral. Yeah? Yeah? Sorry? Here is an HEE, and this. Oh, no. I don't understand now.
Small t
understand. Sorry?
You are taking small t integral on the left hand side, small t or capital T?
Ah, you mean here?
Yeah. Ah, okay.
Yes, it doesn't matter. It's for any t. Well, okay.
Partition matters.
Yeah, maybe I should. Yeah, okay. I should obviously put here 0 t if you like, yeah? But this for any t1 minus then tn less than t big, and maybe I should put indicator function. Thank you. Yeah. Okay. Maybe I should also change it here later. Okay? So, okay, this is fine. Now, this integral is an isometry. I am displaying. So this integral is an isometry, and this is really nice because. So the Itô integral. So H L. Is an isometry. So the following holds. So let H be a sample function. Then we can immediately see that the expectation of the second moment of HS. Let us do it to time t, because I'm now interested in that, big T, is equal to the second moment in the L2 space of H. So this was the norm, yeah? So this is the norm we had in the space of martingales, and we know that this is a martingale here. This is a martingale because it is the sum of independent increments, right? So this is a martingale. And so maybe I should say then the integral of 0 HS in the LS is a martingale, which is in MT2. Of H, and an isometry holds, which means that this norm in the martingale space of H, of the integral of H, is equal to d of the norm of H in the space L2. I think we denoted it like this. Yes? So this was the space L2. So we see that as in the space L2, the sample function are dense, it will be easy then to prolong the operator E, which first was defined on the sample function, to the space of martingales. It will be easy to prolong it in a continuous way from what we call the L2 space of this L2 space to the space of martingales. Due to this isometry, because if we have a Cauchy sequence here converging to H, we will have a Cauchy sequence here in this norm. So you can continue this operator, prolong it in a continuous way here due to this isometry. But maybe this theorem, I will prove it next time, and I will again say what how the Zito integral is defined simply by prolongation. And then I will mention why you can do it in some cases also for balanced spaces. The cases are when you have here an inequality instead of equal, because the principle is the same if you have a balanced space. But here you have an isometry.
The importance is to have a kind of continuous injection.
Yeah. And you have it because of the isometry. And in case of balanced spaces, you can prove that the Ito integral is defined if and only if you have for the sample function this inequality.
Where the operator is continuous in some sense.
Yeah, so this implies that you can, by the same principle, continue the operator here. Yeah, and the question is when is this inequality true? People think sometimes only on M-type 2 Banach spaces, it's not true. M-type 2 is a sufficient condition, but not a necessary.
So there is no equivalence criteria to say that the operator is continuous?
There is no, I mean, on M-2 Banach spaces, if A instead A, you have this inequality, so you can prolong in continuous way. But you might have, for one Levy process, the inequality, even if it's not the Banach space of M-type 2. But if you have the inequality with the same constant for all Levy processes, in that case, you know that the space has to be type 2. But this is another question. I won't speak here about that. Yeah. Okay, I'm sorry. I'm a little bit. I hope to finish this. I'm sorry that. So I will start from this theorem here. The proof of this theorem, and then again this discussion, which I hear made in a fresh way. Okay, thank you.